Hello, it's my pleasure to share with you throughout this presentation the summary of my research topic as a PhD student in the Faculty of Polydisciplinary for the ZED on titled An Improved Orthogonal Polynomial Approach to Solve Wave Propagation in Cylindrical MEMS Resonator. The design and the conception of microelectromechanical system resonator require efficient tools of modeling for achieving high quality factor and then achieving expected performance. Several modeling tools were reported in the literature. We have one-dimensional modeling based principally on the analytical method. For example, we have Meissner model, equivalent circuit model, Laplace transform model. One-dimensional theory is applicable since the piezoelectric element vibrate only in one dimension. We have also numerical modeling, for example, finite element method, but for large or radiating structure, finite element method can lead to high computational expense and storage requirement. In order to overcome those problems, assuming analytical method were proposed to solve the problem of vibration in piezoelectric structures. As early as in 1972, orthogonal polynomial approach was developed to solve line acoustic waves in homogeneous semi-infinite wedges. After that, this approach has been used to solve various wave and vibrational problems, from acoustic wave in wedges and ridges to surface acoustic wave in layered and inhomogeneous semi-infinite structures. Later on, it was extended to investigate Lamblike gated acoustic waves in multi-layered and functionally graded materials. Recently, a lot of effort were made to extend this method to study microelectromechanical resonators in a three-dimensional structures. For example, here we have a homogeneous cylinder of infinite length made up of a piezoelectric materials with R and H radius and the thicknesses of the disk respectively. Taking into account the symmetry of the structures, it seems sufficient to only study the half structure. The disk is divided into two areas, the inner area and the outer area. Two thin electrodes are applied from the top and the bottom of the disk. The structure is driven to vibrate by an alternating electrical source. So the piezoelectric disk is polarized parallel to the thickness direction as shown in this figure. Acoustic behavior of piezoelectric MEMS resonator is driven by the equation of motion coupled with the characteristic equation of piezoelectricity. The polynomial approach has one specificity. It directly incorporates the boundary condition into the equation of motion using three window function, one window function theta q1 following the axial direction and p q3 following circumferential direction. The continuity condition also of mechanical displacement component and electrical field. Equation of motion is then converted into a matrix eigenvalue problem thanks to an expansion of the independent mechanical and electrical variables in an appropriate series of orthogonal functions of Legendre polynomials. From this equation, two analyses could be performed. Model analysis allows calculating resonance and anti-resonance frequencies, and we have also harmonic analysis allows calculating normalized input admittance. Here we present some obtained results with polynomial approach. We calculate resonance frequencies and anti-resonance frequencies. We calculate electrical input admittance. We calculate radial and axial component of mechanical displacement represented in a three-dimensional configuration. Those results are confronted with result reported in the literature. We have presented an extension of semi-analytical method based on Legendre polynomials for calculating the vibration characteristics of piezoelectric MEMS resonator disc composed of piezoelectric materials in case of partial centralized metallization. With a single calculation, the method is able to retrieve the resonance and anti-resonance frequencies, normalized electric input admittance, displacement profiles, and mechanical coupling coefficient for all modes. The validity of our method was done through a comparison of obtained results with those presented in the literature by analytical method. Good agreement was confirmed. The extension of polynomial method in case of partial annular metallization is in progress.